So let's add a second condition. This second condition is going to make use of the logical anding. We're going to say if the temperature is greater than, or the level is greater than 90 and the temperature is greater than 250. So we'll choose AND conditions. This simply pairs together two comparisons. So as you can see, it brings up a new dialog box. And we'll do essentially what we did before. We'll make a comparison. We'll say if the level is greater than 90, no dead band in here, but that is available. And then we'll add to that a second condition, a temperature is greater than 250. So for the input, we'll look at all the different attributes. Here's the one we want, temperature greater than 250. We'll go ahead and say OK. Now here's a feature that can save you a lot of what are sometimes called nuisance alarms, you know, in manufacturing. We can set the time true to something large that would be unambiguously true. So for example, let's go with 10 minutes. We're going to say when this is true for 10 minutes, then we definitely have a condition that's worth notifying. So that right there should solve a lot of the problems that you normally see with, you know, within notification systems where you just simply get too many alerts and people start to ignore them. Now the last thing I'd like to do is assign this a different state than what we saw before. We'll say that this, when these two things are true, then we've got a state of high, not shutdown. So we've got two so far, two of these comparisons, or two of these different triggers. And our last is going to be a performance equation expression. So I'll choose new condition. We're going to choose performance equations. Now this is where we would put in our expression using performance equation syntax. So I'm going to type in tag average. This is where, again, if you're not familiar with PE syntax, you're going to have to go look at that help file. It's basically going to be the name of the tag or the name of the attribute. In this case, I'm going to use the name of the attribute, temperature. And the first argument is the name of the attribute or the tag. The second argument is going to be the start time. I'll say asterisk minus 1 hour. That stands for 1 hour ago. And for the end time, we'll just choose asterisk. And we're going to specify when that is greater than 300 or equal to 300. Now I can check to see if the syntax looks good. I'll go ahead and evaluate. And currently, it's false. So that would lead me to believe if I were to, let me just do a sanity check here. If I were to say less than or equal to, that's going to come out equal to true. So that looks good so far. Let me change this back to greater than. And as I said, if you are interested in more information about that PE syntax, just go ahead and look. Here it is again, Program Files, PyPC Help. It's called PE Reference. Now since this is even higher than what we saw before, I'm going to change the state here to go high, high. So we have three states we're looking for, either shutdown, high, or high, high. And using these three different conditions, we're going to, you know, have the opportunity to flag any one of those. Well, so far so good. Let's go ahead and check in our work. Again, in AF and notifications, checking in is the equivalent of saving. Now next up is to subscribe some people to this. Again, we'll do this using our Active Directory search as we've done in the previous examples. I chose subscriptions. I'm going to look in contacts. I'll do a new search. Let's look for all the users who begin with the letters RU. We should have one, and that is Rudy Wells. This has actually gone out to Active Directory. This is an Active Directory server here, and we're able to find any user who's an Active Directory user. Move this over so you can see that, yeah. So, and as we've done before, I'll drag Rudy's email contact or email mechanism over here, and that subscribes Rudy to this notification. Now, if this is the first time I've made use of Rudy in using this email, you will see an options dialog appear. I'm going to go ahead and clear this notify on close, and just go ahead and set this so that we only get the message when the notification occurs. Okay, let me go ahead and check in our work. And our last step would be to go ahead and start up this notification. As you can see, some of these other notifications, they're already running. This one I just created, it's not running. I'll go ahead and start up this notification. And let's take a look at the history real quick. Let's see if we've got anything here. I don't think we're going to see this trigger on its own. So what we're probably going to have to do is go into our Pi System Manager and go into the data archive or the data section in the archive editor. And I'm going to force some values into, let me force some values in here to force this to change. And that'll force a triggering. So this is our Pi SMT. Now again, if you didn't see how I did that, I went under All Programs, Pi System, and this is the, where did it go? Pi System Management Tools. Now within there, I'm going to choose Data, Archive Editor. Now I'm going to look for the tags that I need to tweak here in order to trigger this particular notification. So what I need to know is what that tag name is. And there's a couple ways we can do this. One of the things I can do is I can go into my solution database, choose the element device status, and then take a look at some of those things that we were monitoring. We're monitoring the temperature. The temperature, as you can see, is actually pointing to a tag called CDT158. So that's the tag whose value I need to edit here if I'd like to make use of this. And so once I know what the name of this tag is, I could go in and using this archive editor, I can add some values to force the last hour's worth of data to have an average greater than 250 or greater than 300, which was one of our conditions. So now that you know the name of this tag, we can go into the archive editor and change the history so that the 1 hour average is going to be greater than 300. If you recall, that was what our trigger was. If we go to notifications and look in the trigger here, here was my condition. Make this a little bigger. It was the tag average of that this temperature tag, CDT158, in the last hour is greater than 300. So we're going to need to modify the history in order to force that to happen. So that shouldn't be a problem. We'll go ahead and do a tag search in the archive editor and find the tag CDT158. I'll do a basic search. We'll look for the tag CDT. And there's my tag. And as you can see, it's had values in the last hour. If I would just retrieve an hour's worth of data, the last hour, it's been around 140. Well, I can goose this up pretty well if I just put in some very, very high value, like 1,000 or something. 1,000 was too low, so after a couple of tries, I did this. So let's go with, how about we'll add a value of 30,000. I'll go ahead and save. Now let's evaluate. And right now the value is true. The expression has become true. So if we look in history, we should see that the notification has triggered. It's actually triggered, though, using the shutdown state. Now, that's interesting. That means that one tag has taken a value of off. Let's see if we can go back and look at the recent ones. Let's see if this other one fired as well. Now we're seeing shutdown has fired several times. Let's see if we get it to evaluate this other. Now our evaluation here is based on natural scheduling. And natural scheduling means that it's going to evaluate this each time there's a new value that's added to the one of the input triggers. So what we should see is when there's new value, when new values do come into this, these evaluated, trigger tags like CDT158, we should see it redoes the calculation. And there we go. It looks like now that trigger has finally fired. We see that the high state has been reported, which is an indication that this trigger right here, this is the one that was triggering a high result, that has finally, it has finally kicked in. So that's our exercise. Now the other way to check this is to verify that Rudy Wells is getting these emails. So we'll go out to Rudy Wells' email address and take a look, see what kind of emails he's getting. Now, again, if you haven't seen this before, within this particular environment, we've set it up so that you can log in as any one of these users. I'll go ahead and launch Outlook, logging in as Rudy Wells. If you get prompted for a password, the password is student. So let's take a look, see if he's getting any email. Okay, there we go. Yeah, if you take a look here, we have gotten those emails. This was the first one indicating it was a shutdown. Where's our value? Shutdown. Second was a shutdown. Third was a shutdown. And the fourth one here, this email notification is indicating high. So that's the one that we just set up. And again, we tested that by goosing the values here, putting in values to give us an average that was over 300. And Rudy, because he's subscribed, is going to get email notification of that. Now, another way you can log in as Rudy is if you go down here to the Outlook link, do a right-click on that and choose Run As. Then you'll be able to choose the user, R. Wells. Password's going to be student.